ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
All I ever wanted.
This is crazy, y'all. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser. I don't like people either. I don't care if you're Nas or Jigga and want to meet you. Just give me my motherfucking
We're
going to
be located at the Westchester Town Center, 198 Central Ave, right lane, New York, 10606. $100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free. Start sending in your funds today. For booking information, check us out on the ISUPK 51st Annual Passover Facebook page. More updates will be available soon. Last but not least, Israel, Commander General Yahanna will be accepting the men willing to stand for the Hebrew Academy 2021. The Lord's 51st Annual Passover.
We are the ISUPK out of 1 West, 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yahanna. Right? This is the ISUPK in Trinidad and Tobago, and we are not affiliated with any other religious organization on the face of the earth. Right? Anybody else that says Christ is black, they are liars. If we say Christ is black, we are speaking the truth.
That's right.
If anybody tells you the sky is blue, they are liars. If we say the sky is blue, we are speaking the truth.
That's right.
Right?
The book of Jude, chapter 8 and verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. You understand? And the truth is that the Christian pastor is a damn liar.
That's right.
That's right.
The Christian leaders are liars.
That's right.
And they have been leading black people down a drain.
That's right.
You understand? They are the number one cause for black on black crime, the Christian leaders. You understand? And what is also the truth? We are going to also bring up the truth about the mark of the beast. What is the mark of the beast? Can anybody know or tell me what is the mark of the beast? You understand? That's what I thought. You understand? The Christian pastor says that the mark of the beast is a shit. The mark of the beast is not a shit. You understand? If the mark of the beast was a shit, we have break all the chits on you, and there have been no more mark of the beast. You understand? Some say the mark of the beast is worshiping the Lord on a Sunday. That is not the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast is Christianity. Christianity is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
You understand? Islam is the mark of the beast. Egyptology is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
The white man's doctrines and philosophies is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
The white man's science is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
You understand? The white man's DNA testing is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
That is the mark of the beast.
You understand? So give me Revelation 15 and 4. You understand?
So again, anybody says Christ is black, they are liars. Don't listen to them. If it is not under the ISUPK, it is not in the truth. They are liars. Only we alone speak the truth on the face of the earth.
You understand? So give me.
The book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 4. And they that worship the dragon, which gave power unto the beast.
And they that worship the dragon, meaning all the other nations on the earth, does worship the dragon. Now in Revelation is a vision. John was seeing a vision, so it's not literal, right? You have to know the context. Again, you have to come in this school and understand the context of the Bible. John was seeing a vision.
That's right.
He saw a dragon, not where you just see it on TV or cartoon, not that kind of dragon. But what does a dragon do? A dragon does fly in the sky and breathe fire through its mouth. What does the white man's military do? He sends spaceships or jets in the sky and drop bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
That's right.
We drop bombs on Black Wall Street.
That's right.
That is the dragon that John the Revelator was sowing. He was seeing the white man's military in the sky dropping bombs on different nations.
That's right.
That is the dragon in the Bible. The white man's military.
The book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 4. And they which worshipped the dragon, which gave power unto the beast.
Right, so all the other nations worship this dragon. They worship our so-called oppressor, which gave power unto the beast. The Lord calls the other nations beasts, just as how we call Israelites. He called black people sheep. We are the Lord's sheep, but the other nations, the Lord call them beasts. Because why? A beast does devour sheep. That is why the Lord calls us sheep and call them beasts.
Well. And they which worship the beast say, who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him?
Right? And all the other nations watching this dragon and saying, who is worthy to worship this beast? All of them are scared and frightened because why? Because of the military might of the white man. His jets. When the jets fly in the sky and they drop bombs on different nations, everybody watch this beast and say, who is worthy to give power unto this beast? You understand? All of them are scared. You understand? So the Lord calls us beasts. The Lord calls the other nations beasts. But he called black people sheep. You understand? That is what's going on here. The dragon is the so-called white man's military. That is what John the Revelator was seeing. The white man's military in the sky dropping bombs. That is the dragon in Revelation. You understand? Not where a Christian preacher telling you the dragon is Game of Thrones. A dragon is not where you see on Game of Thrones. That is what John the Revelator is seeing here. He's seeing a military. You understand?
Good word. The book of Ezekiel, chapter 34 and verse 8. As I live, saith the Lord God, surely because my flock became prey and my flock became meat to every beast of the field.
Right, so the Lord called us, he said, we, our flock became meat to every beast on the field. He's describing the other nations as beasts. That is what black people do. You understand? That is how we just talk. And the Lord, he's a black man. Just as how Christ is a black man. We just talk in metaphor. That is how we like to talk. We like to talk in a spiritual way. You understand? That is how black people are speak. And this Bible was written by black people. Black people wrote this Bible. So that we just talk in a spiritual sense. So we call the other nations beasts. And the Lord calls black people sheep. So again, we are going to prove what is the mark of the beast. Mark of the beast is Christianity.
That's right.
That is the mark of the beast. Christianity is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
So much of black people killing each other because of why? The Christian church, the pastor encouraging crime amongst black people.
Right.
That is the mark of the beast. Christianity.
The book of Genesis, chapter 3 and verse 1. Now, the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field.
Right, the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field. Now the Lord does call all other nations or all other races. The Lord does call all other nations beasts. But this nation, this particular race of people here, they was more subtle than any other beast on the field.
Was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made.
So this serpent, he was more subtle. This nation, this one race was more subtle than any beast of the field. Now they call him a serpent. Could a snake talk? Because we all know a serpent is a snake. A snake cannot talk. That is strike one that we know this is a particular race of people in Genesis.
That's right.
In Genesis, the Lord created a flock of human beings. It wasn't just Adam and Eve alone. It was a flock of human beings. And in this scripture here, this serpent, there was this, again, the Bible is written by black people. So any black man talk, they saw you describe people in metaphors. If I and an ex brother go and thief or rob the bank and he snitch on me, I will call him what? A rat.
Right.
It don't mean he like cheese and he have a long teeth with pointy beard and a long tail. That's just how black people are store.
That's right.
You understand? So in this scripture here, this race, they call him a snake, a serpent. This particular person was a serpent and he was more subtle than any other race on the face of the earth. I just saw black people on store. When we see the police, what we just call them pigs. It don't mean every police officer like to eat crap on the ground and just go oink oink. It don't mean that.
That's right.
I just saw black people are talk. We are talking metaphors.
The book of Revelation, chapter 12 and verse 9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil, right, and Satan.
Right, so that great dragon was cast out.
Go ahead.
Was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan.
Right, so that old serpent was where? In Genesis chapter 3, what I just read. So that old serpent was called the devil. You understand? That's going straight back into the Old Testament. You understand? This is describing the so-called white man. When they look up the word devil in Greek, because the New Testament was written in Greek, it is diabolo, which means a deceiver.
That's
or
right,
a slanderer.
Right. That's right.
That is what it means. So could a snake that cannot talk deceive people? No. You understand? That is another strike again to prove that the snake was a human being. It was a race of people. It was the so-called white man who's our oppressor on the face of the earth.
The book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 12. And he exercised all the power of the first beast.
Right? And he exercised all the power of the first beast. The first beast I gave us talk about another nation, another race of people.
Go ahead.
And causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed.
Right, whose deadly wound was healed. So that first beast, now remember we talking about the mark of the beast. What is the mark of the beast? That first beast was Rome. Rome was the first beast. So that if it have a first beast, what is the second beast? The second beast is America. Why? Because America follows after the first beast, which is Rome. You understand? That's what America follows after the first beast, which is Rome. And what was the power of Rome? White supremacy. That was the power of Rome. But America resurrected the power of Rome. They resurrected that first power, which was white supremacy. You understand? And they gave back power unto the life of the beast.
The book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast.
Right? And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast. Who is he? He is America. Gave power unto the life of the image of the beast, which was Rome.
That's right.
Who was that power? Who was that image in Rome that gave Rome that power? Caesar Borgia.
That's right.
Who the Christian pastor called Jesus Christ. You understand? Jesus Christ is not a white man.
That's right.
You understand? Jesus Christ does not have long ten years. You understand? Jesus Christ, as you all know him as, have woolly hair, and he's a black man, just like the black man in Silas and John and Labre and Bitum. That who Christ is a black man. God is a black man, just like the black man in Lavantil and Mova. That who God is a black man, and that's who Christ came to save. You understand? But America gave back power onto this white image called Caesar Borgia. You understand? Caesar Borgia was also a flaming homosexual. That is who he was. And then the Christian pastor put him up on the church and saying to worship this white image. Christ is not a white man. Christ is a black man from the tribe of Judah.
Book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak.
Right, so that the image of the beast should speak. So when you see the white man named Sija Borgia in the pastor church speaking, what you say? God love everybody. We should all come together and hold hands. Why? God is not a racist. God love everybody. But when you open the Bible, it's saying different to what the pastor said.
That's right.
The pastor said, God love everybody. Because why? You get that from the image, Sija Borgia. You understand? But when you read the Bible yourself, black man, you'll see that God only loves black people. God only cares about black people. And Christ died for black people to rule the face of the earth.
And cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed.
Right? So that is why it have war in the Middle East right now in America. It have war. Because why? Them people in the Middle East, them Arabs and them don't want to follow Christianity. Them Arabs and them don't want to follow the democracy of America. That is why it's always a war with the Middle East and America, because they are not following the image and the beast with America resurrected in Rome, which is Sija Borgia. Those Arabs and them have their own culture and lifestyle. They don't want that white image come across here. You understand? And meanwhile, people who worship the image of the beast getting raped, robbed, molested and oppressed in the Christian church.
That's right.
The pastor does molest people in the Christian church.
That's right.
That is what the pastor does do. The pastor does molest little boys and girls in the Christian church.
That's right.
So why other keep sending other children to church and the pastor molesting them?
That's right.
Stop sending your children to church.
That's right.
And then open up all eyes and see the pastor molesting them. The pastor destroying marriages. He mashing up marriages, he mashing up families. But that way does do when they worship the image and the beast.
The book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 16. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads.
Right? He causeth all small and great. This is talking about countries now. He calls it small countries, great countries. You understand?
And he calls it all, both small and great.
Right. Small and great countries. Go ahead.
Rich and poor.
Rich and poor countries. America, rich country. Poor country. Brazil, Haiti, poor countries.
Go ahead. Free and bond.
Free and bond. Where is a free and bond country? That is the third world country. Trinidad is a free country, but we still bond. We still in bondage. Why? Because we always tied up in the IMF.
That's
the
right.
International Monetary Fund. That is the mark of the beast. The
That's
International
right.
Monetary Fund is the mark of the beast.
Right.
Everything that white people portray as our own against us, that is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
Right.
Christianity again is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
That's right.
The white man's science is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
Not that shit. If a chit was the mark of the beast, just break all the chits and there will be no more mark of the beast. You understand? But the mark of the beast is something more technical than that.
But free and bond to receive a mark in their right hand and their forehead.
Right, to receive a mark in their right hand and in their forehead. In the Bible, your right hand is your strong hand. So your fighting hand, your military hand. So the mark, people who fight for the white man, like who goes in the white man's military and fight for him, they have the mark of the beast in their right hand.
That's right.
They're fighting for the mark of the beast.
Right. And in their foreheads.
And in their foreheads. People who believe in the white man's doctrine, people who believe in the white man's philosophies, they have the mark of the beast in their forehead. That is what I'm talking about. The mark of the beast is talking about the so-called white man and his Christianity, and his science, his Egyptology. That is the mark of the beast.
That's right.
ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover. All
I ever wanted. This is crazy, y'all. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. This place is gonna be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser. I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't wanna meet you. Just give me my motherfucking check.
We're gonna be located at the Westchester Town Center, 198 Central Ave, right Plains, New York, 10606. $100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free. Start sending in your funds today. But do they trust for booking information, check us out on the ISUPK 51st Annual Passover Facebook page. More updates will be available soon. Last but not least, Israel, Commanding General Yahanna will be accepting the men willing to stand for the Hebrew Academy 2021. The Lord's 51st Annual Passover.